Good afternoon, guys, and happy Monday to all of your sunshiny faces. Guys, I was kind of good and ended up actually writing in my planner, although I don't have any room. Normally, I always would leave my planner sitting out on my desk so I could see it, you know, and then kind of check, like, oh, did I get to that? Did I not get to that, you know, that today or whatever, you know, things that I had going on and stuff like that. I don't have enough room on my desk to leave it sitting out. So I actually wrote in my planner for this week only to not be putting it out anywhere where I can see it. It's shoved in a drawer right now, which is where it was. But I told you guys, the one I got for Christmas, it was on clearance. I don't remember how much it was on clearance for, but it was for like a 12 month, but it was like the school year. Although it does have like summer and all that kind of stuff in there as well. But I liked it because of the way it was laid out. Now, it doesn't have like the weekends or anything like that, obviously, in there, because it's supposed to be for like a school like calendar. I think it's really like, here's the thing, guys, you could totally, if you wanted to, use it as a like school planner, like if you were in like middle school, high school, college, or whatever, because of the way it's laid out, because it's almost laid out like classes, so you could just like write, like, if you have homework in it or whatever. It's actually really smart, and you could also put things in there too, like for like other things that you have going on or whatever. It could work really well as a planner. For that, I really truly feel like if it was a teacher's planner, which is what it's actually meant to be, it doesn't seem like it would fit well enough. Like, it doesn't seem like there's really enough room to write, like, for like each like period, I think it's supposed to be, at least kind of how it's laid out. But I really liked it because the only other ones that I saw at the Walmart we were at didn't have like lines, and I like to write on lines. It would just like open blocks for like the days and stuff like that, which I didn't like. The one I have now, or the one I was using for this last like year, I stinking loved it because the way it was laid out. It had lines, and it would go through like, you know, the days of the week or whatever, and then on the other side, like at the very bottom, it had like a spot for notes or whatever. But I really liked the way it was laid out, and like I said, it had lines in it too, so I could write. None of the other ones, again, that I was looking at had that, except for this teacher's one. So I was like, you know what, I'll just get that because it's on clearance anyway, because it was only for like the rest of the half, like the rest of the, like, till summer pretty much. And I believe, again, it includes summer as well, so by the time summer rolls around, I need to look for a new planner. But that should give me enough time to like try and find one, hopefully. Like I said, actually the last three planners I believe I bought were all on clearance, because I buy them when it's just like the other half, like if it's like a 24 month calendar or whatever, which I like the ones that are actually set out for the whole year, not the like undated ones either. So if it is like laid out for the year or whatever, normally I'll buy it for when it's just like the last 12 months or whatever, and normally it's marked down to be like, instead of 20, a lot of times they'll be like $7 or $8 or something like that, because like, who wants to buy like a planner that's meant for like 2 years when you're only getting it for one? So sometimes it'll be like between like $10 to $7, which is obviously just half of the planner anyway, what it would cost, or sometimes less, so that's really good. But yeah, like I said, I ended up getting this one, and again, I can't remember off the top of my head exactly how much it cost. It might have been like $5 or something, but I got it for Christmas. I just know because I went and picked it out, and like, again, it was the only one that I really liked, but I knew I did need one because obviously at the end of this year, mine was running out, so I wanted to at least get something that I could try and use. So I did end up writing in it, but again, my desk is so messy right now, I don't even have a place to really like lay it out. So I need to stinking get to cleaning my room tomorrow. And I honestly, guys, I did kind of feel inspired to like try and get some stuff done. And then we ended up going to Aldi and Menards today. We also ended up going to, where's the other place called? Oh, well, Jack came with to go grocery shopping because he wanted to go to Best Buy. So what we actually ended up doing was we went probably over, it feels like a half hour away, maybe it's about like 20 minutes or something like that, to go to Best Buy, because there's really no Best Buy really close to us at all. So we ended up driving a little ways away. We went to Best Buy, and I knew that there was an Aldi there, guys. Honestly, I love this area, that the Best Buy, you know, where we went shopping is, because they literally have every stinking store you can possibly imagine. Like, just think of a store, guys, 90% sure it's probably somewhere in that area, and it's not within like 10 minutes of like that street or like that area or anything like that. There is an Aldi that we ended up going to, which this Aldi, guys, was so stinking cool. They actually did have a fresh bakery in this Aldi, which I thought was so crazy. So they had like fresh donuts and bagels and like all these other kind of like cookies and stuff like that, which I've never seen in an Aldi before. I've shopped at several Aldis and I've never seen that before. This one again was in like a very nice kind of like super classy, you know, like again high-end area with again like Whole Foods and Trader Joe's and all these other kind of, you know, like fancy, not fancy, but just like, you know, like health food stores also. And so they had a ton of stuff that I have never seen at an Aldi, but or stuff that like our Aldi only carries like I think more seasonally, or I've only seen like our Aldi like carry for like a short period of time, and like this Aldi had like all that stinking stuff. Obviously, I think that taxes were probably more in that area, I feel like, because sometimes I believe that you can have, it's county taxes. And so I noticed that too, guys, when I started couponing though, when we would shop at this one Walgreens, it was actually more like more expensive tax wise I believe than at this other Aldi. I think I know there's state tax and stuff like that, but I believe the tax on certain foods is different also, but then again that's also based on prepared food and not prepared food have two different taxes in Illinois. Again, I'm not necessarily sure, but oh yeah, they do have county taxes, so I actually do think that the county taxes might have been higher there. I'm not totally sure, which again might have been a little bit not as worth it, but they had a whole ton of stuff that our Aldi does not normally carry, or again it's only like seasonal, but they had theirs in like a normal like spot where they would most likely, more than likely, normally carry it, because a lot of times they will have like a seasonal tag on like you know the sign or whatever that says like just seasonal, like they don't normally carry it at the store. But there's a couple of things that, like I said, I've seen there that our Aldi doesn't always carry, or even to some of the other Aldis I've shopped at. But I thought it was so cool. Plus, too, in their freezer section, because I think their freezer section was maybe a little bit smaller, actually, than ours, because I think it was making up for because of where the bakery was. But they actually had this really cool, like, in the middle, like, chest freezer sort of thing. But then it also had, like, I don't know, overhead, like the regular like door freezers over the top, but they were like only from like, you know, here, whatever, up. And then from like below that was like chest freezers as well, which ours just has chest freezers through the middle of like the dog just sat on the chicken and got totally freaked out right now. He has no clue why or how it made that noise. And he's staring at it now, thinking that it's gonna make another noise. Anyways, guys, he was scratching himself and then rolled over on the toy and it just squeaked. But guys, like I said, it was just so cool, and like it was so, it wasn't a huge crazy different layout, but compared to some of the other ones that like I've been to, a lot of the Aldis are laid out the same, and this one was super like different. Like I said, that they had like the bakery and where the way they had all like all their frozen food set up was different and stuff like that, but it just seemed like a much more classy Aldi, I guess, because like the way too they had like all their carts set up and stuff like that. They were behind this little wall and stuff, like, so you couldn't see the carts if you were like pulling up, because at first my dad was like, where did they keep the carts, like we couldn't see them. But I knew that there was an Aldi there, because when we come in off the street sometimes to go to I think there's a Hobby Lobby there and like an Office Depot maybe or something, I don't remember if I'm thinking of a different spot, but a lot of times you have to wait for all of the people that are shopping to like, because you're coming in not off the street but off the side street, so there's always like people, you know, going through and, you know, coming out the store and stuff like that with their carts, and a lot of times it like takes forever. So then like I just remembered that, and then also too, I think by the Dick's Sporting Goods there's another kind of store too that's like not a health food store but just more of like a, like, you know, a Whole Foods, like a healthier food store. I think it's like a, I don't even know if it's a chain store, it's like something market, or like not a Whole Foods but a, like, just like maybe farmer's market is what it's literally called or something like that. But I know there's a Trader Joe's in the area, I'm pretty sure that there's a Whole Foods, there used to be a Sam's Club before literally all the Sam's Club closed. There is a like I said, like this Aldi, there is that other type of like, I think it's more of like a health food, not a health food, but you guys know what I mean, like just like a more like, you know, they have like, you know, dairy-free stuff and vegan stuff and vegetarian stuff and just like healthier, more organic food and stuff like that. Like at, you know, those type of stores or whatever. And we used to not, I never shopped at, and my mom really never shopped at Trader Joe's, but my friend's mom was like very into like holistic, you know, like remedies, you know, organic food and all that kind of stuff. And she literally would almost always shop at Trader Joe's and like, you know, occasionally they shop at Aldi, but a lot of times, like, I think they just, like, did that for, like, maybe more stable stuff or just, like, fill-in stuff, but a lot of times, like, I remember always, like, you know, like, when I was little, I would hang out with her, like, all the time, and, like, her mom would just take me grocery shopping, you know, like, it wasn't that big of a deal, but I remember going to, like, Trader Joe's, like, all the time, and I never bought anything, like, there, you know, I was always good, too, and never ended up asking for anything. It was normally my friend who'd be like, can we get these cookies, and stuff like that, because I didn't want to be like, oh, can we buy all the food in the store, and stuff like that, or I really have a taste for that, or, you know, whatever, but, I just remember her mom, like, going to, like, Trader Joe's all the time, and I think it was this Trader Joe's, maybe, that's in this area. I just remember my mom, like, never shopped at Trader Joe's, even though I really want to, because, like, I see people post about, like, you know, and just share, like, all their food from Trader Joe's, like, all the time, and I get to see, like, kind of stuff Trader Joe's carries, and I'm like, oh, that sounds really good, like, I really want to try that and stuff, but I never go there. I've been to a Whole Foods a few times, but, again, not really, like, grocery shopping-wise, you know, or, like, it was normally, like, if we were going for, like, something specific more, or, like, I don't know, but, yeah, guys, we ended up going there today, and then we went to Menards that was right across the street because we need to get dog food, and then we ended up going to, like I said earlier, and we went to Best Buy for Jack, but this area, guys, I was like, I just would, like, probably spend way too much money being in that area, because I'd be like, oh, like, let's go to that store, but, you know, it's just, like, they have, like, all of the specialty stores, like, you know, it's not just, like, okay, like, just go to Walmart and buy everything you could possibly think you need at Walmart, like, you need lotion, you need, you know, you need lotion, you can get that at Walmart, but you can also get it at Bath and Body Works. You need, you know, new nice dinner plates, you can get those at Walmart, or you can get them at Pier 1, guys. You need, you know, just regular groceries, like milk and stuff like that, you can get it at Trader Joe's, or again, just at Walmart, you know, like, you can get everything that you need at Walmart, but you can't get, like, the specialty stuff, and that's what I feel like this is just, like, oh, like, just keep driving down the street, oh, you need an electronics store, there's Best Buy, or, you know, there's probably another, like, two other, like, electronics stores that sell electronics or, you know, that kind of stuff. Again, like, 8 different grocery stores, they're all there. You know, what kind do you want? They do also have a gigantic Walmart and a huge Target as well, that are just set up like literally like department stores. The way the Target's set up, it's set up like a department store. Like, I mean, like, it almost reminds me of like a JCPenney or like something like that. Like the way, like, all the displays and stuff like that, which is not how our Target, the one that we normally shop at, is the other one that's near us, we shop at, it's kind of set up like that, but, like, I don't know, I guess that's how most people's Targets actually are, but I realized ours isn't normally like that, but this Target on top of that is also huge, and it's set up like crazy, like, you know, like I said, there's just, like, stuff everywhere, it seems like, and I get way too overwhelmed, like, especially during Christmas, we went there, and like I said, it was, like, a department store, like, you can't, like, look at, like, you're like, oh, look at that, like, you know, like, I just, like, when I'm not as, like, overloaded by having to look at things to try and find something, like, you know, I just kind of want to browse, and I feel like too, the bigger stores, there's way too many people, in which case I can't browse as much because I feel like I can't stop and, like, look at something because there's like 80 other people walking next to me or behind me and stuff like that, and I can't stop to look at a display in the middle of the aisle. I feel like that might take away kind of from, like, people when they're, like, shopping. And maybe that's why. Maybe that's a smart business tactic, is so that you just throw it in your cart and you can't even, like, look at it to know if you actually want it or not. You're just like, oh, slippers, throw them in the cart. Like, you know, that kind of thing. Instead of being able to, like, look and be like, do I want these or not? Like, you don't have enough time because 80 people are going to run you over because they're all behind you. Anyways, guys, yeah. So that was fun, though, to kind of go to a different place that we really haven't been. But surprisingly, too, guys, was not busy at all. It really took us was almost no time, but I found a few goodies that, again, are Aldi doesn't normally carry that I was able to pick up too, which is kind of fun. So anyways, guys, I will see you all in tomorrow's vlog. If you guys did enjoy today's, make sure you guys give a big old thumbs up. If you guys are new, we'd love if you'd subscribe, and I'll see all of your sunshiny faces tomorrow. So bye, guys.